Ladies and gentlemen.
Good evening. I'm Joe Tessitore alongside Teddy Atlas. The opening bell of this scheduled 12-rounder here. A much-anticipated fight. Round one underway. Good body shot. The right hand came home. And now just wasting everybody's time holding on. Iron Mike with a big uppercut. Takes one to give one. He comes back with a right hand. Scores. He is not in good shape. He could be on the deck in moments. Stunned, but all of a sudden now, surviving. Gets rid of that effort. Tyson was hurt. Now Tyson looks to have his feet back underneath him.
Yeah, but does he have his mind right? Is he still going to be the seek and destroy fighter that he's been before?
Mike Tyson's trying to create a gap between himself and his opponent, and you see how he's doing it. A little push-off. Hooks to the head. So right from the start in this fight, he's committed to the body shots.
Well, that's the time to go there right at the beginning, because body work pays off for you later in the fight. No sense in wasting time. Get right to it.
He got all into that one. That was a solid uppercut. Flush right hand to the head. Teddy, what are some of the things you look for early on when you get a big puncher against a guy that really likes to take the fight to the inside?
I think the big puncher, he's going to start drooling. His eyes are going to light up like he's seen a big, juicy steak. Catch the guy as he's coming to you. Don't wait till he gets inside. You know he's coming in? Tee off on him.
A crushing two-punch combo by Joe Frazier. Zones in on that overhand right. Keeping him honest with the double jab up top. Tyson's defense did a good job there, able to avoid that punch.
Finish with the hook.
Goes up top, and bang, and away he goes. He just fought the other guy's fight, and now it's not his fight at all. He is down.
No, he should have been on the inside. He pulled out into a world of trouble, a world of punches.
Good right hand. A flush hook scores well for him. Doubles up the jab. He got hit, but he sends it right back.
Keep your distance.
Blocks it away. Final 10 seconds. Gets rid of that. It was intended for his head. Back to the head he goes. 3 minutes gone by in this round. Tyson's got such confidence there. Look at the corner. You can tell. They just know that this fight could go their way. Scored a knockdown. Now they have momentum. Keeps his hands up defensively, protecting the head. Tyson's in a bad spot right now. He's been stunned. Oh, he's hurt right there. He is hurt. You know, his opponent's doing a good job of just being patient now and looking for that one good shot.
Well, you know, the landscape of this business, the history of this business is littered with guys that they've had someone hurt, they get a little careless, they get caught. He better watch out that he doesn't get put on that landscape.
Great work offensively landing that combination by Joe Frazier. Protecting his head well with his guard. This is really solid defense by Mike Tyson. You see how he has his arms up in that peekaboo position, but by doing so, he's not allowing any of his opponent's punches to get in.
Inside, inside.
Doubling up the jab by Joe Frazier. Look at that. Mike Tyson is on his pants. Iron Mike's got to get back up.
One, two, three, four, five.
Down he goes, but he's going to continue on, beating the count. And now committing to that midsection as the target with the combination punching. How about that left hand? Oh, that's got to hurt. Joe Frazier trying to rise up, as he's done so many times in the past. But tonight, he's already done it before.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Get up, damn it!
Frazier's going to keep taking this test, rising up after being knocked down. Oh, what a hook upstairs! Frazier's doing well here with that two-punch combination. Wow! He was able to get up and continue on last time. Now he goes down again. Tyson's not going to hear from those judges. He's a knockout victim.
By way of knockouts, your winner, Smokey Joe Frazier.
There's a lot of explaining to do here, but help me with this. Was this early knockout out of left field a product of one guy being prepared and the other guy just not ready for it?
No, obviously he wasn't ready, wasn't prepared in the gym, but I think he came out cold from the locker room, never knew what hit him.
Thanks for being with us, everybody. For Teddy Atlas, I'm Joe Tessitore. Have yourself a great night.